So, welcome back to episode number 3. I've had some feedback. Thank you for the feedback. Apparently the volume was still a bit of an issue. I've applied a 10 gain filter now in OBS. So that should be better. The music of the game should pick up a bit better as well. Like I said in the first video, I'm still new to this. I'm still exploring all the things I need to do. So yeah. Anyway, another question asked by the same guy, thank you for your comment, was about the sending of volunteers to Spain. Now, I've just checked it after he asked that, and I could send Spain 4 volunteers, but I'm not that keen on it. It would be good to gain some experience, especially the army experience, but I don't really have enough divisions, I think, at the moment to do that. I am really quite worried about China becoming a bit of a pain in the neck, really. And I'm not too keen on having that kick off, really. So, I'm doing my national focus. That happens when you go off screen to start the timer. I'm doing the national focus of the Chinese puppet. And then last night, after I switched off the game, I all of a sudden thought for a minute about this. Isn't this actually going to trigger the war anyway? What if China says no? So, yeah, I'm not sure now. I might be in this war sooner than I actually anticipated. What might be a good thing, though, is if China says no and declares war on me, then the world tension shouldn't go up too much. So, I'm going to get ready even more because, yeah, I really need to be prepared for this thing. Did I send those out? Yes. Right, let's run the clock and see what comes of all of this. In a way, it would be very exciting to get to war, of course, because that's why you watch these Let's Plays, but it would be a bit sad if the Let's Play started off on a very bad note, that's the word I was looking for. Which sort of bombers are those? Oh, I think that... Oh no, it's still the interwar bomber. I was thinking that might have the range to get anywhere. Ah, here we go. Right, I wasn't wrong. So we're at war. A bit sooner than I anticipated. Oh, we're not at war. What is going on? I'm a bit confused here. The incident happened and I'm not at war. Oop. I would like the map to switch back to that mode after you do something, but there we go. Right, we might as well run the clock again. Yeah, they don't like me. That's not surprising. And they hold our core provinces. Well, we're going to hold far more of your core provinces if it's down to me. Am I going to send those bombers over anyway? Well, yeah, they're not going to do a lot here, are they? There. I wish I had an airport here. I might actually build one. Yes, I think that's a good idea. Wonder where it's going to put it, but it shouldn't actually matter too much. Let's put some new interwar bombers down. I haven't even got those here yet, so I should have checked that in the previous episode as well, really. But we are still preparing. Am I training my boys? No, they don't need training. Okay. I was playing an America game earlier today, and 42, I think the year was. Full blown out war, and my computer couldn't really cope with it. This is something that unfortunately happens with the Clausewitz engine that Paradox uses. Hearthstone 4 uses an updated version, but in all their games that use that engine, towards the crunch time, if you like, when it gets really busy, this was particularly true in Hearthstone 3, it just slows down so much, it's ridiculous. I'm playing this on an iMac 5K with a... I think it's only an Intel 5 Celeron. No, not a Celeron, an Intel 5 i5 processor. And 8 GB of RAM, but it should go better than it is doing. So if I run into trouble with that, I'll have to get some more RAM and upgrade. 46 divisions they've got out here. Crikey. Yeah. The other thing I'm a bit worried about, and that happened in the America game I was playing, was that the whole of China united against me. So then I'm not just dealing with these boys, I'm also dealing with these boys. Who've got quite a few... Oh, actually, they don't have that many divisions. So that's all changed as well with respect to Hatzfeind 3, because Communist China was a pretty strong opponent in that game. Mainly due to the landscape. This is all mountains, and that's actually one of the big problems we've got. I should invest some time into researching mountain divisions, but I haven't done. And I don't think I'll have time to do that before the war starts. So we'll see how it goes. The infantry might have to just hold the line for quite some time and slug it out. Actually, that's not a bad idea. Do I delete that? No, it shouldn't make a difference. If they get over this river, they'll be quite happy. Yeah, we'll leave that be. So we're waiting to see what is going to happen here. Are these evil Chinese going to declare on us? Are they going to just submit and become my puppet, which would be ideal? I don't know. I've not played this yet, so just trying it out. Playing it by ear. I did set up some of my subs to go out. Yeah. So these early stages in Hatzfeind are always a bit tedious. It's more about rushing to the right research, rushing the right amount of troops out, and getting the production going. Which I think we're doing alright with at the moment. I did add those, didn't I? Yes. Next time when I start recording again, I probably should check my last videos just to see what I have done and haven't done. That's all gonna take ages. 16 days. I'll put it back up. Have I got any unassigned troops yet? No. Where do they deploy to? Koshinetsu. Okay, somewhere on the mainland. There we go. Check your constructions. 4 factories. 4. That is dreadful. That is so bad. I suppose it's actually quite realistic. In World War II, the war with between Japan and China that started in 1937 actually didn't stop. Basically, Japan pushed and pushed and pushed, took bits of the coast and all that. But they never actually signed a treaty to say that the war was over. And I've been to Wuhan. Ah. Right, let me finish that story. I've been to Wuhan, which is here. It's on the Yangtze River, and that became the capital during all these struggles that they had. So, yeah. Oh, it's just a war goal. Okay. That gives us a bit more time. Actually, I should check how long that war goal takes. Oh, I don't want a China focus tree. Looking at the thing, why can't I select anything? Yes, I definitely want to do that. I don't want China to get any bonus in the infrastructure type thing. And a war goal doesn't seem to expire. That's handy. That's very handy. So we do have some time to do stuff. Oil from Iran. I knew that was going to be a problem. We'll cancel that then. Maybe get some more. That's not ideal either. 14. That's all I have to do for now. I've got a 5 surplus, so I'm not too worried. Resources don't actually store. They can be used for trade going out again, but that's not really happening with limited exports. Who's got... Oh dear. Do I worry about that? No, they're going to have to take it out, I think. Why are they there? Oh, they're not, they're on that. In those mountains. Okay. Right, so what I intend to do now that I've got the war goal, is get these boys out. Have they got light infantry yet? No, light tanks, none at all. Am I actually producing light tanks? Of course not. Ugh. So this is a great start, isn't it? Do I deploy them without light tanks? I might do. Because otherwise I'm waiting forever for them to get ready. We'll be finished on the 16th of April. Yeah, we'll wait for that and then we'll declare war. We might as well. Now, to make sure that we have a bit of an advantage, we better get one of these with our political power. Do we want to be offensive or do we want to recover? We've got really big divisions, a lot bigger, I suspect, than the Chinese, so this is a difficult one. I really like recovery, it stops you bouncing back quite a lot. It gives you more morale, things like that. Yeah, we're gonna go for that. I think we actually have quite a lot of recovery bonuses at the moment. Yeah, because of the Shintoism as well, so that's doubled up. So that's pretty good. We should recover quite quickly then. This attrition, of course, is really bad for the recovery because the attrition is constantly taking down their organization, which is exactly not what I wanted. Ah, if I'm not mistaken, and again, paradox, this is a request, I should have my troops ready. Oh, right, if this unit is fully equipped. Screw it. We'll put them out, and rather than them, we'll train more of these because we've got the materials for it. And the other thing I want to train is Marines because we've got the materials for that. How many can we actually train of them? 9, excellent. We'll limit those, we'll keep that going. So now we have our poor pawns here who are going to struggle to get anywhere because they haven't got the right equipment. I'm going to assign them to a group and exercise them, and then it's time to push the button. Is it? This could be suicide, you know. I'm going to gamble with the air cover and the coastal advantages. We're just going to start this line. Let me guess, we've just lost our war goal. Why didn't I see how long it took? Oh, that is so annoying. I looked at it, it didn't show anything, did it? So now I've got a penalty. and it's gonna take ages. Oh well, at least we could prepare this way. So now if you're watching this, you probably think I'm a wimp for not going to war. No, I'm an idiot for not realizing that the goal was expiring. If anybody can tell me how to find out where it expires and when it expires and things like that, then I'd be very grateful. I think we've just built our... oh, we haven't. Oh, the heavy cruiser, right. So, what we're going to do, that's nearly done as well. That's nearly done. I think what I want to do at this point is pump out some light cruisers, because they will help my carriers out. Is that naval? It is naval, so we might as well bump them up a bit. And either it's going to be the engine, which I like because they're a bit quicker closing down the enemy, or the reliability. Now we'll go for the engine. These guys, oh, or anti-air. These guys aren't supposed to, no, anti-air is already good on those. Aren't really supposed to do all the damage, they're just supposed to close down the enemy and try and take them out. So we're going to build a host of these. As many as possible, please, thank you. Thank you, Germany. I could, of course, go the other way. And set up myself to avoid fighting the US. No, because I want war with them. I'm going to the Axis anyway. I also get a few. Is that all I get from that? Decisions. Soviet border is important as well. And then I could declare war on the UK, who will be busy against the Germans. And take... That might be worth doing as well, you know? Or rush down to the extra research slot, which is always handy. What do I get for them? Land Doctrine. Oh, I love Land Doctrine. And I got more people. Yeah, we'll go with that. 70 days. 1938. Have we got enough points? We do. We are going to declare for Beijing. I'm really annoyed that I didn't realize that that war goal was expiring. That is just stupid. Having said that, I wasn't quite ready for anything. These guys should be training, and they are. Oh, they're already trained. That's good. In that case, you can go straight to the China infantry, who now have too many men, but I think I've put some interesting... motorized. I'm gonna take those out. And add those to the mobile army. Give them just a bit more punch in case we need to fight through here. To be fair, that's probably a bad idea because they have all the mountains here. And these mountains here are really bad for motorized. They're okay for cavalry, I think. But actually, I should probably look that up. Right, I've been talking about doctrine. I better get some doctrine. And then the other thing I want to do is make sure I've got these set up. It's too early. Signal companies are very useful because they help prepare orders quicker, so they're faster in getting ready. And logistics in these conditions are probably even better. I've got my Air Force sorted out more or less, because I can't build any planes. I don't want to worry about that. I'm going to go for quicker research, construction. Right, one of the things I wanted to look up was if these guys... mountains. Oh, they've got a recon company, so they can actually get through mountains. That's interesting. Okay, well, in that case, they can stay with that army. They might be good then for that northern push. Have my regular troops got a recon company as well? Yes. Recon companies are so useful. I could change these boys up a bit more as well. They've already got artillery. No, I think I'll wait till I've got some of the other support companies ready. So because I've got my ships out here, I can see what they've got here. And frankly, it's not a lot. If those are their regular troops, I don't know what the boobing thing is. But if those are their regular troops, then those are tiny divisions. Can I find out the difference? Infantry type 1, Sanjo Jun... 11th of June 1. And they're Bubingxi. So I'm not sure what is what. I would think the 1st Infantry is probably their main. That looks actually like a division that they've designed. So our war talk is going up. So I don't know what to expect. 17 to 38. 45 horses in one. Okay. Yeah, their infantry type 1 look like they're the big ones. Because here there's 242, 27 to 50. And here there's 43, 27 to 50. Yeah, definitely. Okay. Unless, of course, the lack of intelligence is screwing me over. Which is possible. So, the 3rd episode. I was thinking we would have action this episode, but... it doesn't really look like it. That's a shame. Bear with. 29th of January. Well, we'll push for that. I'm not producing any light tanks yet. Because I don't have enough factories. Spiritual mobilization. More recovery rate. Wow, that is so powerful. But I want that research slot more than anything else. Should I have waited doing the doctrine? Nah, I already had the 50% bonus on it anyway. And this might enable me to push straight on for the next one, so I don't think that's necessarily a big issue. I've got a carrier fleet here that isn't doing anything. Oh, these are all my new ships. Right. I might actually have to add those to the... what was that? That's weird. What's this called? Kanto. I thought you could just click on the province, but maybe I clicked outside. I'm putting all my new ships in one place so I can find them. I've still got my big old collection of ships here. And, let's form a particular battleship group. Basically with the idea of bombing the knocking daylight out of our friendly Chinese coastline. when I finally get an opportunity to go to war, that is. Again, I'm selecting just the destroyers that are similar. We've got an awful lot of battleships in that group. I like to have a minimum of three screens, but again, we're fighting China, so this fleet alone is probably twice the size of their fleet. I think that should do. And then we call this the Daylight Fleet. And we will assign an admiral to this thing as well. And our Daylight Fleet is going to sit here with the carriers. I can deploy. Oh, yes, please. Throw them in with that lot. Oh, they've not been assigned to the... I was wondering what was going on with them. Put them there. Going to start a second army that is going to help on that front line, but they don't know it yet. And I'm not going to push these in yet because I'm worried about the supply situation. But I will have them ready to go at a moment's notice. On combat weight is really useful. Got radio detection, which is always... Oh, are the marines ready as well? Oh, that's even better. Maybe this doesn't work out as badly as I thought it would. Research. That was radar, which I will want to start building once I've got some industry. But I'm tempted. Now let's go for that. Every bit of research advantage we can get, or production advantage we can get, is worth having. You don't have a job. Well, tough. So these marines, I'm going to use for a landing on Qingdao. Do I prepare them for that already? Yeah, why not? We'll call them first marines because I anticipate needing quite a lot of marines. And we will... Oh, excellent. Grand battle plan. And we're immediately going to give them the order to leave from... Nagasaki straight into Qingdao. So after the battle starts, I want to push them in. It's a bit risky, but when I reach this line, I can't remember what river this is, but when I reach that line, I can do that and then we can connect up, is the basic plan, if we ever reach that line, of course. Army motorization, no. No, not yet. Research slot. Ah, and I had another 50% bonus, so that's going to go really swimmingly. So the problem now is that the more of these troops are pushing this line, the less I'm going to have supply. I mean, it's all right here, but up here is going to be very difficult. So, I think that concludes this episode for now. Thank you for watching. My name is Dr. Clumber. This was episode 3. I hope the sound issue has been resolved now. And if it hasn't, then I will play about it some more. Right, thank you very much for watching, and goodbye. Oh, and actually, next episode, war. Unless I forget about the war goal.